multiple example of that in so many different domains, and that's why I prefaced at the beginning of our conversation by saying this: these are the things that you do, equal to any guy or whomever is out there. You're just, seems like you're just out there competing and want a fair shot to compete, and not only are you able to compete, but you're actually able to accomplish, you're accomplishing things. And speaking of accomplishments, you're a junior, you're away from school, but you seem like you've set your mind on where you're going to school. I'd like to know, what was important in that decision process for you in terms of the school that you've chosen to go to, where you want to compete and continue your athletic career playing soccer? What were the things that were important to you in that decision-making process?
Of course, the most important thing to me was not being too far away from my little brother. I know it's a really small thing to some people, but being close to my little brother is one of the main important things in my life. And Grand Canyon, which was where I committed to, is out of state, but close enough.
And that's in Phoenix, Arizona, is that right?
Okay. Correct, Phoenix, Arizona. And it's far enough where I could, you know, have my own space away from my parents, feel the feeling of, you know, relying on myself. But I could also drive back and watch my little brother grow up, because he's 12, and, you know, just see him go through life. And of course, oh, go ahead.
No, I was gonna, it drew me to this. Is your brother competing in sports?
Yes, right now he's playing soccer. He's played flag football and basketball, but as of right now, he's playing soccer.
Okay.
Yeah.
And go on, there's probably more that you want to add to that. Please do.
Yeah, and also in the process, I just wanted to make sure, like, if I didn't have the chance to play soccer there, would I still go there? Because, I mean, of course, tomorrow's never promised, and if I go there, I could get hurt. Stuff, you know, everything can happen at any given moment. And when I was looking at Grand Canyon, I said, wow, this school, soccer or not, I would love to go here. Just the atmosphere, and they have neuropsychology there, because I would love to study neuropsychology and become a neuropsychologist. And yeah, I think that's one of the biggest things while deciding a school where you're going to go to for 4 years of your life, maybe more, is deciding if your sport, if it didn't work out with your sport, then would you still want to go there?
Rayon, you just touch upon a subject, and we were discussing this a little bit earlier, that I think is critical in the college process, okay, the college decision process, the college recruiting process. And I will hit on this, and you guys out there that listen to us, and you know part of what we do, a lot of what we do, is try to work through the college recruiting process and help you understand that a little bit better. This young lady just nailed it. The idea that she would attend a school, irregardless of whether she played a sport there or played soccer there, that her decision, and don't let me put words into your mouth, her decision to attend there had a lot to do with whether or not you played soccer or not, but you enjoy the school. You mentioned what you wanted to study. I'm going to try, because I'm not that bright, but I'm going to try to repeat what you said in terms of what you want to study. Neuropsychology?
Correct.
That is incredible, okay? So that took some work for me to be able to get that right. So, but that is absolutely incredible. I would love to hear an explanation of what that really is. You don't have to do that now, but just that alone, folks, understand what is really critical in all of this, not just performance, not just the fact that you physically have the gifts and talent to do this, but in the end, ask yourself, am I going to the school simply because of a person or a process, or is this the place that I would be irregardless of whether or not sport was a factor? And I think you definitely nailed that, okay? Lastly, and so appreciate the time that you've given us and this conversation. Lastly, you know, talking about where you're off to go to college and what you've decided to do, what should your college coaches know about you? What would you like them to know even more? I mean, there's a lot there to know. Is what else should they know about Rayon Jones, the person, who you are, what you're made out of, and what you're looking forward to, and what you're able to give beyond what you already do?
I mean, of course, I will work my hardest. That was already a given. But I just know that I'll be able to bring the best out of the players that I'm working with, and I feel I have pretty good character, you know, when people aren't looking what I do behind the scenes and stuff, and just I'm willing to push other girls with me along for the ride and just never give up.
That is outstanding. I just want you to know this too, as we sit here and talk, and had a chance now to really kind of have this kind of in-depth conversation with you. You are going to be an influence, not just on other young ladies, you realize that, but on other athletes. That you are certainly a positive influence on all of them, and wanted to know how you feel about that, and possibly being, for us, and what we do in our business is to do positive promotion of the student athletes, of their programs, of their schools, and those things. You no doubt are going to have that influence. What does that mean to you to be able to have that kind of, particularly on upcoming younger female athletes? What does that mean to you?
It, of course, means the world to me just to think that, like, last year I didn't, you know, I was just playing soccer, minding my own business and everything, but now to have, like, this kind of platform to influence and inspire other athletes and, of course, young females, it means everything to me, especially because I have younger girl cousins and stuff that I would love to make sure I inspire them to make sure that they do whatever they want to do and whatever that they know that they're capable of.
That's just outstanding, and I hope people really tune in on this and think about what this young lady is saying. I think there's probably no one I've talked to a lot of folks, no one more genuine than the way in which you've responded to our conversation today. So I thank you very much. It's been an absolute pleasure to have time to sit down and just have a chat. Remember, I told you we were just going to chat and that type of thing, and you're doing a wonderful job. It's exciting. We want to be able to follow you and continue to follow up with you because your progression is going to be really, really fun to watch. And I know you're just really just kind of getting started with things. So we'd like to do that, and we'd like to encourage our folks and our listeners and our watchers and our fans and our support system to watch HSPN and watch this young lady. Watching HSPN is very simple. We're subscription based on YouTube, and all you have to do, Rayanne, you can do this with me too. There's point this way. There's a little bell on the side, and you just hit the bell. Okay? Ding, ding, ding. You hit the bell and you're subscribed to HSPN for all sorts of rich content. This is the best part of what we do, and having a chance to sit down with young, aspiring athletes. Okay, student athletes who are putting effort into the classroom, putting effort into their communities, and those types of things. And this is the best part of what we get to do. So, again, I thank you. HSPN is happy to sit down with you, happy to be able to follow you, and wish you the best in your endeavors. I'm sure we'll be talking again too, and soon too. And just be ready. You're going to have a heck of an influence on this emerging generation of female athletes, and I know you're ready for it. Okay, I know you're ready for it. Once again, David Hill on the campus of Chino Hills High School. You can see practice going on behind me. And we're sitting here with Rayanne Jones, who had a spectacular, I know her team, she would have loved to have her team come on top on Friday. That's all. That's what an ultimate athlete wants. But they were competitive, 63-60. She made all of her extra points, and she's going to continue to score all throughout her life. David Hill, once again, with HSPN Sports West.
Thank you.